Getting started with Altivar Soft Starter ATS-480. Hello, today we will show you the essential steps to install and set up your ATS-480. We will guide you to install, wire, and commission your ATS-480. Unpack the ATS-480 and verify that it has not been damaged. Install the ATS-480 inside a cabinet. The product has to be mounted vertically, as shown in Getting Started, along with all other mechanical constraints. For the power part, we will follow this diagram. Q1, circuit breaker, short circuit protection device for the motor. KM1, line contactor. Q3, fast-acting fuses, to be used only when type 2 coordination is required. T1, transformer. Q2, circuit breaker, short circuit protection device for the primary of the transformer. Q4, circuit breaker, short circuit protection device for the secondary of the transformer. Q5, circuit breaker, short circuit protection device for the control part of the soft starter. We start by wiring the ground cable and the motor cables, then the mains. To access the control terminal blocks, remove the cover. The control supply admits a maximum voltage of 230 volts AC. Remove the red sticker. Wire the ATS-480 control supply. The CL1 and CL2 terminals must be supplied within 110 to 230 volts AC. Wire the ATS-480 control terminals. The relays of the ATS-480 admit a maximum voltage of 230 volts AC. In our example, we will configure the ATS-480 to run a centrifugal pump. Power on your soft starter. At first power on, you must go through the initial setup procedure. You must set the language, time zone, date, local time, and set the cybersecurity policy. In this example, we select Minimum CyberSec to set no credentials and access the main menu. If you want to set credentials, select Advanced CyberSec or download an existing configuration. Now we set Access Level. It will change the parameter's access restriction. Here we select Standard. Once it's done, go to Simply Start menu. Set the following parameters according to your motor nameplate. Motor nominal current determines the current of the motor thermal monitoring depending on which motor protection class is set. Current limit. The RMS motor line current will be limited to current limit times motor nominal current. Mains voltage. Maximum voltage applied to the motor. Set the following parameters according to your needs. Acceleration. This parameter sets the ramp time from no torque to nominal torque. Initial starting torque. It's the initial torque setting during the starting phase. If set too low, the motor starting may be delayed when the run command is applied. We set type of stop to deceleration, as it's well adapted for this kind of application. We can now set deceleration. This parameter sets the deceleration ramp time from the estimated torque at stop order to no torque. Then we set end of deceleration. As soon as the estimated torque is below the value sets in end of deceleration, the motor stops in freewheel. You can now start your motor. If you are in three-wire control, power on your soft starter by pushing S3 and send a run command by pushing S5. To stop the motor, push S4. If you are in two-wire control, power on your soft starter by pushing S3 and send a run command by switching S6. To stop the motor, switch back S6. We apply a run command. The motor is starting. We apply a stop command. The motor is stopping according to type of stop. You can check the status of your ATS-480 with the LEDs. Refer to the table above to check the LEDs' status. Scan the QR code in front of the soft starter to get your product information, technical documentation, and error codes explanations in the diagnostics section. Thank you for watching. For more information, please visit our website.